everybody, and welcome to Rowan University's Faculty Spotlight Series. I'm Marion Stever, and I just wanted to tell you that in the music department, we choose our dates way ahead of time, like over a year ahead. And I thought we'd be finished with the pandemic by now and back to singing full recitals and so, but when the fall came and the Omicron variant was around and we didn't know what was going to happen with that, I decided to make an abbreviated performance and invite some of my colleagues and friends to join me. So it's going to be a short program, but we're going to have a lot of fun. And I am totally honored that these friends and colleagues have joined me on this evening's program. So anybody that knows me knows that my favorite composer is Bach. And so the first piece on the program is going to be by Johann Sebastian Bach and from Cantata 140. And joining me to sing this duet is baritone William Marshall.
It's like when I'm one in a million at the nerd's convention. As for lessons, my students arrive on the dot, and they're always prepared with a repertoire.
Thank you.
Now, don't get downhearted. I'm just getting started. I'm tired of those same boring pieces, those clunky pianos, no tenors, no baritones, no just lyric sopranos. It's sneezing and coughing and muscular tension and bodily functions I'd rather not mention. And starry eyed students who got me like lilies, all certain is they become pretty.
Octavian, I'm going to be playing the part of Octavian, the young knight, comes to deliver the silver rose as a betrothal gift to young Sophie von Faninal. He's never met her before. He's the bearer of this betrothal gift. And she's being held in marriage. It's an arranged marriage to a much older gentleman who is not very nice. So in this moment, the whole court is there, all of the staff and the relatives, extended relatives. It's a big moment. Octavian comes in and offers a formal greeting, saying, "I'm here to bear this rose." And young Sophie answers with another formal greeting. And then when she is held, given the rose, she notices that there's a fragrance, and she mentions it has a fragrance of like real roses. And Octavian answers that, yes, there's a little Persian rose oil on the flower. And she says, "It's as if it's from heaven, not from earth. Don't you think so?" And she offers the rose for Octavian to inhale the fragrance. And as he bends over and does so, and he looks up, they have a moment where they look into each other's eyes. And from that moment on, everything that's spoken is their innermost thoughts. And she says, "Es wie ein Gruß von Himmel." It's a greeting from heaven, and says, "It's as if bonds have been, tethers have been wrapped around my heart, and I'm being pulled in this direction, in this moment." And then she says, "Where have I been before and felt such a holy moment?" And he says the same words. And she says, "I want to go back there. I want to go back to that moment. And if I die along the way, at least I'll know that I shared that special moment." This is the presentation of Rose from Der Rosenkavalier. And please welcome Christina Beeler to sing Sophie.
Thank you.
an ordinary life. So, of course, he had to sing.
Oh.
we were all grief-stricken and shocked. And the music department, within less than 2 weeks' time, put on a concert with all of its ensembles participating, faculty participating, and I sang this song by Roger Quilter. Singing it again, Mom, a little early.
Oh, fair princess, most beautiful and charming. Her father, the king, was a wicked old thing with manners most alarming, and always on the front door mat a most ferocious dragon sat. It made such an awful shrieking noise, so all you little girls and boys, beware, take care of the green-eyed dragon with the ugly tails. He'll feed with green, or little boys, puppy-noted big fat snails. Then off to his lair each child he'll brag, and each of his dirty tails he'll brag, beware, beware, and creep off on tiptoes. Then hurry up his lairs and say your prayers and duck your head, your pretty curly heads beneath.
When I of the leading lady. That is my character as well in this aria. Antjen is the best friend of Agatha in Der Freischütz, and I had to lure in, work with Professor Hofstadt to see if I could get her to come be my Agatha today. So I did make that happen. She's going to play that role for us today. So enjoy.
Oh, Have